In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use email marketing for your business, and I'm going to share with you 7 tips and strategies used by the pros. Let's get started. Hello, fellow business owners. If you are new to me or this channel, we talk all things marketing to help you grow your business. So if you want more content like this, please make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss a thing. Let's get right into it. So why email marketing? Well, first of all, people still love email marketing and spend an enormous amount of time in their email inbox. According to Adobe email survey of 2019 in the US, 56% of people surveyed said that they prefer to receive an offer in their inbox versus 6% via text or 4% in social media. And we spend an enormous amount of time checking emails on a daily basis. Some 209 minutes a day on a professional account and 143 minutes a day on a personal account. That's 5 hours a day that you and I spent on average in our inbox. So let's start at the top with the first tip, and that is the subject line. Yes, the subject line is super important if you want people to actually open your email. 60% of our decision to open an email is based on the subject line alone. Based on studies conducted on millions of emails sent over the last 10 years, here's what we know for sure. Number one, the subject line length doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. Second, high performing subject line always include a feeling like surprise, like happy, like frustrated or overwhelmed. And third, the simpler, the better. For example, two of my best performing subject line was the grammar test, which got a 27% open rate, which is amazing for my industry. And my second best performing subject line of all time is my favorite tools, which got a 26% open rate. All right, let's move on to the second tip, and that is the from name. The from name is a lot more important than I thought. 70% of people said that they delete an email based on the from name alone. So let's not mess up that one. For starters, we'll be a lot less likely to delete an email if it's coming from a real name. For example, an email in your inbox coming from Catapult Marketing is much more likely to get deleted than an email from Antoine Dupont. And that makes sense. A company name is most likely going to send me an advertisement of some kind versus a real person. So you're much better to use your first and last name rather than your company name in your email marketing campaigns. Now, if you need to use a company name, here's an interesting case study from Drift. They tested the following on hundreds of thousands of emails they sent out. For the from name, they used the following combinations: Dan from Drift, Dan Smith from Drift, Dan at Drift, and Dan Smith at Drift. The results showed that the first option, Dan from Drift, got a 27 times more likely for someone to click than the other three. So if you were me and you had to use your company name, it would be Antoine from Catapult. Moving on to tip number three with the ideal format. The straight answer is that less is more. The cleaner and the simpler the format is, the better it is for you. People don't respond well to large graphics or pictures all over the place in your email marketing. Between you and I, in 2020, the best option to go is text only, no graphics. Or if you're gonna have graphics, have very little of it. First, a lot of your audience is probably going to open up your email on their mobile phone, and those large graphics and images rarely transfer well to mobile. Second, people are super busy and all those graphics and tables simply get in the way. Now, resist the temptation to use all those fancy templates that the email service providers are making available to you. And why they look really fancy on paper, I can assure you that if you do an A and B test with a text only and a heavy graphic, the one with text only will win every single time. Now, if you want to add a little bit of graphics to your email, I would highly recommend adding a GIF in the body of your email and maybe one small picture in the bottom, and that's all. Next tip is the content of your email. In 2020, the formal Dear Antoine or any kind of other formal greeting is really not needed anymore. Now, what I would recommend for the content is make sure that you include the word you and your as much as possible. This email is about them. Now, the ideal font size for a title inside the body of your email is 30 points, and for the text is 16 points. Now, why 16 points? It's because it's the ideal size for you to being able to read your email on a mobile phone with your arm fully extended. And personally, for me as an old dude, I prefer 18 to 20 points. It makes it so easy for me to read it. Now, for the content itself, I would recommend value-based content. Give something useful for your audience to read. You may be able to leverage some of your old blogs as content for your emails. The next tip is go for the reply. A recent study conducted by email service providers showed that a reply to an email campaign shows as a super strong signal of authority and relevance. Now, if you want to make sure that your email marketing doesn't end up in the spam folder or the dreaded promotion folder, I would highly recommend that in the body of your email, you include the following. Hit reply if you'd like to connect, or hit reply if you have a question. And when people reply to your email marketing, it sends a super strong signal to the email service providers, and that's really good for you. Next tip is called foldering. This is very much like the reply tip. But when people create a custom folder or move your email marketing from the promotion folder to the primary folder, it also sends a very strong signal to the email service provider that your email marketing campaign is highly relevant. A simple way to make that happen is to have clear instructions when people sign up for your email marketing piece. Like in the confirmation screen of them signing up or the email confirmation in their inbox, have a text that says something like this. To avoid having our emails landing in your spam or junk folder, simply create a rule to have it sent to your primary folder. This will ensure you get the latest offers and deals when they are released. And the last and final tip is how to grow your list. First, let me get this out of the way. Never, ever, ever buy a list. Not only does it ever work, but it's almost guaranteed to have your email campaign be marked as spam. And the reason why is because I have rarely seen an email list that is less than 50% junk. Now, for your opt-in widget or form to collect the emails, consider creating a dedicated landing page. Too often, it's buried in the footer and it's hard to find. And with a dedicated page, you can simply tell someone, go to mywebsite.com/email to sign up. And lastly, please make sure you do some spring cleaning with your email database. An email database is pretty much considered stale after 18 months. So go through your database and remove anyone that hasn't engaged open on click on anything in the last 12 months. Just take them out. They're not opening your email in the first place. That by itself will do a few things for you. First, your open rate and your click-through rate will look amazing with all those people that are not supposed to get your email out of the way. And with a clean list, you'll have an email marketing going out to people that actually want to hear from you. All right, so that does it for today. If you got value, I would appreciate a thumbs up. And before you leave, please make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss a thing. Ciao.